Hi guys, welcome to this course. So on this one you're going to learn how to create non-standard stereotomies, or what people normally call waffle structures. This particular type of representation has its origin in industrial design, where this process is used to prototype complex shapes in a simple way. Lately, it has proven to be an effective way of representing large-scale architectural surfaces and volumes, and in some cases has become the architectural project itself, being Jürgen Mayer's Metropole Parasol may be the more representative of them. This course is going to consist of three main parts. On the first one, we're going to create a parametric system to extract the rifts from a host surface. Then you're going to learn how to code a script to automate all the connections and notches of your rifts. And lastly, we will lay down all the elements in our viewport and label them, so we can later laser cut and assemble them in a physical study model. And before getting started, I just want to make it clear that this is not the only way to approach this. Depending on the surface you want to represent, you realize that you'll maybe have to develop a different strategy. However, this exercise shall give you enough information for you to create your own methods to solve this problem. Okay, so with that being said, let's go ahead and get started with our host surface. So in this case, let's assume that we have three volumes and that we want to create like a skin or a surface around them. So what we're going to do is to use some base curves that I have already here in our reference file. So to start creating our surface, I'm going to activate my 3D curves layer over here, and I'm going to go to my top view, and I'm going to go to my curve tab, and then I'm going to search for my curve from two views option. And what we're going to do here is to create a 3D curve using our reference curves that we have over here. So the first thing that I'm going to do is to select this curve, and then I'm going to move to my right view and select this red curve that I have over here. And as you can see, we have created a 3D curve based on those two curves. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and do the same for the top one. I'm going to go to my curve tab, select my curve from two views option. I'm going to select my outer curve over here. And then I'm going to select this red curve over here. Okay, and then I can simply go ahead and hide these two reference curves that I have over here. So the next thing we're going to do here is to create our surface using a sweep to rail command. But before that, I'm going to go ahead and create a line that goes from this curve up to this curve. Something more or less like this. And then I'm going to type in my command line sweep to. It's going to ask me for my first rail, and I'm going to select this curve. And then it's going to ask me for my second rail, which is going to be the curve that I have here at the bottom. Then as our cross section, I'm going to select this one, and then I'm going to simply hit enter. And in this case, our surface looks all right. So I'm going to leave it like that. So here I'm going to simply click OK. And as you can see here, we have created now our host surface that we're going to use for creating our ribs. Okay, so the next thing that I'm going to do is to create a section line that we're going to use with our grasshopper definition on the next lesson. And to do that, I'm going to select my surface, and I'm going to type on my command line the section command. It's going to ask me a start for my section, so I'm going to click more or less around here. And for my end section, I'm going to click over here. I hit enter. And as you can see, we have created a curve section around our surface. So here I'm going to just make sure that it's one single curve. And as you can see here, that is not the case. I have one curve, two, and three. So what I'm going to do is simply join these ones. Here I'm going to type join. And now it's one single curve. Okay, so then I'm going to go ahead and temporarily hide all these volumes. And to finish this lesson, the only thing I need to create now is a cross that we're gonna use on our next lessons to create our ribs. So I'm gonna go to my right view, and I'm gonna create a couple of lines to create this cross. So I'm gonna select my line option. I'm gonna make sure that I have my grid snap activated, and I'm gonna start making a line from this point up to this point more or less. And then I'm gonna do the same in the horizontal axis. So I'm gonna click here, and then I'm gonna click over here. Okay, so if I go to my perspective view, you're gonna see that I have now this cross. What we're gonna do now is to extrude these lines to create a couple of surfaces, which we're gonna use as planes of intersection. So I'm gonna call an extrude command. I'm gonna make sure that my both sides option is selected. And I'm gonna make a couple of surfaces more or less of these dimensions. Okay, so once that we have done this, the last thing that we need to do is to simply rotate these surfaces by 45 degrees. So to do that, I'm gonna go to my right view. I'm gonna make sure that my ortho option is selected, and I'm gonna simply rotate to my right until I have this X position that you see over here. Okay, so if I turn again back my surface, my volumes, you'll see that we have everything that we're gonna need for creating our grasshopper definition. Okay, so in our next lesson, I'm gonna show you how can you create the ribs out of these geometries.